Thanks for your time. Something uncomfortable about that. Take two. I am the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear parents and godparents, your family has experienced great joy at the birth of your child, and the church shares your happiness. Today, this joy is brought into the church to give thanks to God for the gift of your child, and to celebrate a new birth in the waters of baptism. The community rejoices with you, for today the number of those baptized in Christ will be increased, and we offer you our support in raising your child in the practice of the faith. Therefore, brothers and sisters, let us now prepare ourselves to participate in this celebration, listening to God's word, praying for this child and his family, and renewing our commitment to the Lord and to his people. Communion time, what name do you give your child? And what do you ask of God's church to address it? In asking for baptism for your child, you are undertaking the responsibility of raising him in the faith, so that keeping God's commandments, you may love the Lord and his neighbor as Christ has taught us. You understand this responsibility. Godparents, are you ready to help the parents of this child in their duty? Joseph Richard, the Church of God receives you with great joy. In her name, I sign you with the sign of the cross of Christ our Savior, and after me, your parents will be the same. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the 11 disciples, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord. Almighty ever-living God, who sent your Son into the world to drive out from us the power of Satan, the spirit of evil, and to bring the human race rescued from darkness into the marvelous kingdom of your light, we humbly beseech you to free this child from original sin, to make him the temple of your glory, and to grant that your Holy Spirit may dwell in him. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the strength of Christ, the Savior, protect you, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray, dear brothers and sisters, that God may graciously bestow his abundant life through the sacrament of water on those who believe, that he may be pleased to pour out his grace in response upon his chosen Son. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed with the Holy Spirit, and as he hung upon the cross, gave forth water from his side, along with blood, and after his resurrection, commanded his disciples to go forth and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Look now, we pray, upon the face of your church, and graciously unseal for her the fountain of baptism. For this water received by the Holy Spirit the grace of your only begotten Son, so that human nature created in your image, and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism, from all the squalor of the life of old, may be found worthy to rise to the life of newborn children through water and the Holy Spirit. May the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, we pray, come down through your Son into the fullness of this font, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism and death may rise again to life with him, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Dear parents and godparents, through the sacrament of baptism, the child you have presented is about to receive from the love of God new life by water and the Holy Spirit. For your part, you must strive to bring him up in the faith so that this divine life may be preserved from the contagion of sin and may grow in him day by day. If your faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, then mindful of your own baptism, renounce sin and profess faith in Christ Jesus, the faith of the church in which children are baptized. Before you respond, I'll do. you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty shell. You believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. You believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. You believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Katie and Tom, is it your will, therefore, that Joseph Richard should receive baptism in the faith of the Church, which we have all professed with you? Joseph Richard, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has freed you from sin, given you new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and joined you to his people, who now anoint you as the chrism of salvation, so that you may remain as a member of Christ, priest, prophet, and king, unto eternal life. Joseph Richard, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. And may this white garment be assigned to you of your Christian dignity, with your family and friends to help you by word and example, bring it unstained into eternal life. Joseph Richard receives the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly, so that your child, enlightened by Christ, may walk always as a child of the light, and persevering in the faith, may run to meet the Lord when he comes with all the saints in his heavenly court. And may the Lord Jesus, who made the deaf to hear and the mute to speak, grant that you may soon receive his word with your ears and profess the faith with your lips, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Now let us pray together in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. The Lord God Almighty, through his Son, born of the Virgin Mary, brings joy to Christian mothers as the hope of eternal life shines forth upon their children. May he graciously bless the mother of this child, so that as he now gives thanks for the gift of Joseph Richard, he may always remain united with him in thanksgiving. In Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. May the Lord God Almighty, the giver of life both in heaven and on earth, bless the father of this child, so that together with his wife, and may by word and example, prove to be the first witnesses of the faith of their child. In Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. May the Lord God Almighty, who by water and the Holy Spirit has given us new birth into eternal life, abundantly bless his faithful here present, that always and everywhere they may be active members of his people, and may he bestow his peace on all who are here. In Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God in peace. Thank you.